Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss triple integrals in cylindrical coordinates. Let's go ahead and work through this example. The question reads, evaluate the triple integral of x squared plus y squared, where e lies inside the cylinder x squared plus y squared equals 4, and between the planes z equals negative 1 and z equals 3. Let's work through this solution. So in general, the formulas that you use to do these problems are the following. We have x equals r cosine theta, and y equals r sine theta, and then z equals z. And also, x squared plus y squared equals r squared. So these formulas should seem familiar, at least the first two and the last one here, because they're pretty much just the formulas for dealing with polar coordinates. So the only thing we really need now that's not written here is a formula for dv. So in these triple integrals with cylindrical coordinates, your dv is going to be r dz dr d theta. Super important. I'm going to put this in a box because you need this in all of these problems. Okay, now we're ready to rewrite our triple integral. Let's do that. We have the triple integral. So instead of x squared plus y squared, we're going to replace that with r squared. So this is r squared. And then instead of dv, we're going to replace it with r dz dr d theta. So r dz dr d theta. And so now we just need the limits of integration. So you can think about it visually in your mind, or you can draw a rough sketch. If it helps, I'll draw a rough sketch. So here's the z-axis, here's the x-axis, here's the y-axis, and then here's the negative z-axis here. And so basically, E is inside the cylinder, so the cylinder is going to look something like this, maybe. Okay, again, this is just a rough sketch. And between the planes, z equals negative 1 and z equals 3, so I'm going to use a different color here. So maybe something like this. And like this. So maybe it's this blue region here. So picture does help a little bit, but you can also look here. It's between the planes z equals negative 1 and z equals 3. So we're integrating with respect to z, so the lower limit is negative 1 and the upper one is 3 because it's dz. So you want to do z first, and that's why you put the negative 1 and the 3 there. For the dr, you want to think about the cylinder. Recall that you have r squared equals 4. Because x squared plus y squared is equal to 4. And if you take the square root of both sides, you just get r equals 2. So we're just going to go here from 0, 2. And d theta, you want to go a full revolution, so it'll be 0 to 2 pi. All right. So now let's just go ahead and simplify this a little bit. R squared times r is r cubed, so we just have to rewrite everything very carefully. 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2. It's just a lot of notation. And then negative 1 to 3. And r cubed dz dr d theta. Okay, so first we have to integrate with respect to z. So I'm just going to come over here to give myself some more room. Actually, I just lost room by doing that, so I'll stay here. So we're going from 0 to 2 pi. And then we're going from 0 to 2. And we're integrating with respect to z, so r cubed is basically a constant, so we're just going to get r cubed times z. So we have r cubed times z, and then z is going from negative 1 to 3. We integrated with respect to z, so we drop the dz, now we have dr d theta. All right, let's keep going. This is equal to integral from 0 to 2 pi. The integral from 0 to 2, we plug in 3, subtract, and then plug in negative 1. So we're going to get basically r cubed, parentheses, 3 minus negative 1, right? So it's plus 1. But I'll write it as minus negative 1, so there's no missing steps. And then we have dr d theta. This is equal to going from 0 to 2 pi, going from 0 to 2. It's basically 3 plus 1, which is 4. So we have 4 r cubed. We have dr d theta. Okay, I got messed up there. It's dr d theta. There we go. Too many r's and too many thetas. All right, so we integrate with respect to r, and when you do that, you basically get 4r to the fourth over 4. Because you use the power rule, you add 1 and divide. So you just get r to the fourth. So this is going to be the integral from 0 to 2 pi. And then here we have r to the fourth. And we're going from 0 to 2. And we have our d theta. This is equal to, first you plug in the 2, and then you subtract. We have 0 to 2 pi. Plug in the 2, you'll get 16. Subtract and plug in 0, you'll get 0. And then we have d theta. Finally, we have a single integral. So it takes a bit of work in these problems. And then 0 to 2 pi, 16 d theta. And we have a constant, so when we integrate it with respect to theta, we're just going to get 16 theta. And then we're going from 0 to 2 pi. And then you plug in the 2 pi, subtract, plug in the 0, just like before. You have 16, 2 pi minus 0. And so we get 32 pi, and that would be the final answer. So it takes a bit of work. It's a long computation. Not really a hard problem, just really easy to mess up. You know, you can mix up your variables and stuff like that, mess up a minus sign, things like that sometimes happen. But the important thing is that you know the formulas, okay, especially this one for DB. That's key. Just memorize that one. And then these also, but you probably already know these. These are really easy to memorize compared to some of the other ones like this one. If you've enjoyed this video and you've learned some math, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.